I had the picture in my Bible, just as a reminder. But anyway, he lived. And I left.
That's incredible that you usually keep it in your Bible. I mean, that is awesome.
Well,
that's where your most important things are.
I know I've got it in here. And Cheryl says, well, why do you carry that around? I said, well, that's it. It reminds me.
Well, that's like me. There are certain things that, you know, I don't know, say doubt creeps in or we wonder. Then I'll go back to that day when that guy called you. I'll play that thing where God is able, and I'll look at him and I tell him Jesus is real, and that's, I just feel everything again, and I'm like, why am I doubting? What's wrong with me? Sometimes we gotta remind ourselves.
Can't believe I can't find it today.
But for me,
I got so many little cards in here.
Okay, only one time I've heard the, it was like that, almost like that. I heard the audible voice of Jesus when I had the vision of Jesus, but only from the kneecap down. But follow me. Wow, you knew you had it.
I was gone, dude. I would not have survived that.
You would have been the passenger.
Yep.
Yeah. Right there, that's because, yeah, that went up to where you were sitting. Yeah, there's only like this much room from the seat, from the...
Look at the back of that. The back of the card.
Oh. He spared my life on this day. It's better to obey than to sacrifice. That was a big thing you taught me early on. John, quit worrying about sacrificing and all that stuff. Obey and everything. Oh. Thank you for sharing, because I haven't seen that. I just remembered the story pretty good.
Yeah. So, yeah, the devil tried to kill me several times, but he's tried to kill you too, and you didn't even know it.
That's one thing where I've learned, man, why did I get caught by that light or this? And then, hey, relax.
That's it.
Yeah.
Yeah,
there was a time when the Amore was protecting us in the trailer in certain things, but we were traveling from Houston to Texarkana for a race, and this person was broke down. They went flying by us at like 90. They had one of them turbo diesels, and then they broke down, and it was like midnight, and I stopped to help them, and I'm like, well, I'm going to go check the trailer. Dude. It was just the pin. Nothing. No clip, no nothing. How did I go from Houston to almost Texarkana? I was like, dude, the Lord was protecting us and the trailer, mainly the trailer and all the equipment. So luckily I had the generator, started the generator, drilled it, and then, because I didn't have a clip, so I drilled it and right there on the road. I was like, just so many things that he's done for us.
That we don't know.
No, yeah. Because like you said, he prayed, he knew where one day we were going to. And there's someone was telling me, you know, I think it's in John 6 and then John 7. In John 6, well, only those that the Father has called and will come to me. But in John 7, it says, if you are thirsty, come. So it's your choice if you want to come. If you're thirsty, come. But he does know the ones that are going to come or not come. But some, well, you know, it's just not for me, so I'm not coming. No, it's your choice.
Here's the lyrics to that song. I'm going to send you the song. You can scroll down and listen. Watch them.
Because the waves are all around me, it feels like I'm drowning. Yeah. I got to get back on. I got my little altar thing. I haven't been on it praying like I should. and make excuses and just lay in bed and pray, because I know if I pray, I can make myself go to bed because I'm going to get tired. I got to start giving God my best time, not my, I don't say my worst time, but my time so I can.
My leftover time.
My leftover time so I can make myself go to bed so I can start my day fresh.
Yeah.
And then my nurse.
He understands that.
My mercies are new every day. Well,
yeah.
Well, I got to quit doing that.
I remembered what I was going to tell you about Steve. Go ahead.
Okay.
When you get finished. I'm going to send you that song.
Okay.
Now.
We'll listen to it today. I put it through this, and then I put it through my stereo, and we turn it up in the backyard, and we listen to it while we're working or doing whatever. And one of the neighbors across diagonal, one of them was like, one time she knows someone I grew up high school with, and he goes over there and works and says, you know, one time I was going to call the cops, but it's Christian music. I liked it.
He listened.
And then diagonal across, the one lady, something happened with her son, and it didn't so much matter, but it ended up being that she told him, you know, that got into it with the Jesus guy. And she thought that because the guy across that's an atheist, he looks like Jesus. But they were talking about me because they've seen how I follow Jesus now. And she says it's been a wonderful thing to hear the change in your music from what it used to be to what it is now.
Wow.
And that's for her and her. The dad is a stepdad, but her and her son, and to be able to testimony like that to her son without throwing it in his face.
Yeah.
It's always neat. Sorry.
Well, a lot of it is redundant, but.
Yeah, I was reading that one part was a second version.
So.
Yeah, send it.
I will. Why it's so big today? Let me get off, play it so I can
share it.
So, anyway, Steve.
Why doesn't every home need us at Sorkin?
Sometimes technology is too smart for me. I'm like, man, it's too. I can't figure it out.
So, there it comes. Anyways, so, Steve, here we go. That's when he was little. But he was the first $1 million driver for Team Honda when he was little. There's when he was doing motocross, big time. That's when he was road racing in Europe.
Wow, so he goes. Most don't do both.
He still rides. I mean,
really?
He's just a precious man, just a precious brother. So before he went into one of these races, you know, they do the free race thing and they talk to you and all that stuff, sponsorships and whatever. They said, so we want you to wear this Marlboro bib. So I got my own shirt I wear. He said, well, you can't wear that because Marlboro is sponsoring the race. He said, you have to. He said, I'm not going to wear it. So he pulls out his shirt. You know what his shirt says? Powered by Jesus. His name's on the back.
This guy here, I'll send a picture. He wears shirts powered by Jesus. It's in a circle thing.
That's right. But you know where it came from? Stevie Wise.
Wow.
Back in the... So whenever this was, 82.
Stevie Wise, the motorcycle racer.
Yeah.
Steve Wise, 1980.
Stevie Wise.
Yeah.
He gave me one of the shirts. He had two of them. He gave us one.
Wow.
I wore it for a long, long time. I gave it to my son. Josh wore it for a long time into college. He'd play soccer. He'd take his bib off. Boom, there it was. Last week or a couple of weeks ago, Michelle said, you know that shirt that you gave Josh? I said, yeah. She said, that real old shirt that powered by Jesus? I said, yeah. She said, some guy's doing those shirts now. I went, what? Are you kidding me? So you've probably seen one now. But that's
so that
where
was
it came
the
from.
Marlboro and wouldn't wear it. And
yep.
And this is sort of what came to me about, you know, there's been big debates about can Christians have tattoos? Well, of course they can, but should you get them after you're born again? You know, I don't think so, but there's a big debate going. Anyway, so then this one person, they took down what they said, so I couldn't see it. But so I went and looked at their page, and they're a tattoo person. And yeah, I know maybe Jesus could bring people, you know, into that ministry. But if you're going to do that, I don't think you would put, you know, almost a naked woman on somebody's arm.
Right.
Or some clown faces that look scary. Or for Halloween, you wouldn't put two skulls and tattoo and be out.
Right.
If you're born again, you wouldn't do that if you're into that ministry. I went back and I looked, and you know, and that was coming up, and this person's the one girl that was coming against me for the music. When you know you come against me or my friends, I was like, you got to tell them the truth. You just can't let people do what they want to do. I mean, you don't do piercings and tattoos, but if you're in that ministry, you're not going to do that stuff. I said, like the person who did the cake, I was trying to explain it to Ryan and at least understood it, but he didn't want to get into it. But the people that tried to get sued for not doing the cake for the gay people in Colorado, look, you got a business to do and you don't have to do that. And Ryan's like, well, I don't agree. And something come up about me doing work for some gay people. I said, well, I can only guess. I don't know they are. They don't force anything on me. It's not the same. Oh, it's harder for me to make a correlation into that.
There's a difference in that.
They're not forcing anything on me or telling me,
right,
if you don't come to this party or support me, you can't do my house. I don't know who you are when I go to your house.
The work that you're doing for them is not making a statement.
But I don't, they're not, but to me, they're not telling me they're gay. I just gotta.
But the guy in wherever it was refused to do the cake. If he made the cake, they were taking his creation and making a statement. Big difference.
And see, that was the thing Ryan didn't. Ryan just thought they wanted to make a cake. I was like, no. He's like, no. I'm like, no.
I said,
Ryan, they knew what they were doing. I said, they could have went anywhere to make a cake. They said, we want this cake for us to get our gay. And I said, so there's a difference. You can decide what you do or not do. And that was my thing with the tattoos. If you're going to do it and you're going to follow God, then you don't do those. You can do roses or whatever you're going to do, but you're not going to do evil, demonic stuff.
Right.
Make a stand. No, I want to be friends with everybody. Well, that's not what we're called to do. And that's where, so you're judging, well, no. Well, if I am, I'm judging correctly. That's why I need to study the Greek word. You gave some great Greek words, and then you like metanoia, which I got to study the Greek word for judge, because it's got to be. Like love. Love is not what
that
love
is. That article will help you. That article that I sent you?
Yeah, good.
That'll help you. I'm going to look up that metanoia.
Yeah.
That's cool.
Someone told me about this app, and I haven't downloaded it yet, but when I went to my ministry training, the Olive Tree app. It's a Bible app, and when you go to it, you can scroll through, and every word, you can click on it, and it'll have the Greek word, and you can just click on it, and it'll give you the meaning. It'll give it to you in Greek. Well, we don't got to go look it up, and I still haven't downloaded it yet.
Yeah, that's it.
Yep.
It's Greek.
Yeah. Repent is so much hard. That's what it needs to be here. So we can explain it better.
Changing one's way of life resulting from penitence or spiritual conversion.
And see, that's why I like the Amplified for Acts 2:38. It says repent, but then it says reject your will, accept God's will. Reject your will and accept God's will instead of rejecting it or something. I can't think of it exactly, but it puts it like that.
Yeah.
A spiritual thing.
That's the origin thing.
Changing one's mind. Yep.
Yeah. One time on my Facebook, I put, what was it? I can't remember, but it's a Greek word. And these guys that I went to school with down in at HBU,
yeah,
they started hitting it up. I mean, this is years ago, man. They started hitting me up, Jim, I've been there. That's right. You're right. I can't remember what it was.
Oh, there. Whatever you want to do, that's fine. I got to show you something since you said that. You're talking about Facebook here. I want to say this was yesterday, and you sent it to me. It is the awesomest thing. I think it's been shared a few times. I know you'll remember it when I show. Oh, come on.
Remember sending me that?
Yeah.
That was yesterday. The memory of it was from yesterday. And then he just starts going down, man. It's like so awesome.
I don't even think I have that anymore. Oh, that's funny.
You remember when he's getting ready to start hammering yeah. down? Is he doing? That's when the Holy Spirit gets a hold of you, right?
Yeah. Oh, that's great.
Yep. Oh, so that was yesterday, so that was pretty cool.
That's my Facebook thing now,
mm-hmm.
but I had another one that I was had on there. I don't ever hardly even get on that thing
yeah.
anymore. But I don't know how to go back and look at previous. What do you call those things that you put up there?
Pictures?
Yeah. It's not like, it's not.
No, wait. Is that your, view your main profile. Usually,
I may not be on the.
Usually, you can just go back and change it. You click on it, and you can scroll to other pictures that were on there.
I don't even know how many.
This is it, were those ever your profile pictures or not?
It says profile pictures.
Yeah, were any of those ever your profile pictures? See, that's what it's showing they were. But I don't know if that's just scrolling through your pictures or not. Usually it'll just show you the ones that were your profile pictures and then you re-click on the other one and then it'll be there. But they have been doing lots and lots of changes and updates.
Oh, yeah. That's when we were first married. That's when I had hair. dang it.
What were you trying to find a picture?
Yeah, it's a Greek word. I can't remember. It's not hamartia. Hamartia means missing the mark. Tetelestai.
I know the word.
Paid in full.
Paid in full, okay.
Paid in full. I had a pastor when we were first married that he was an excellent evangelist. And he did a lot of Greek studies, did Greek for it, and that's where I learned a lot of my words. So I didn't take Greek at HBU. I should have. I wished I would have. Because now I could be, they have an English-Greek interlinear Bible.
I have it.
You got it? Where it's got, yeah, I used to have one, but yeah. I couldn't read Greek. I'm like, why should I keep this?
Well, it makes it hard, but what I do is I take, when someone's really giving me a hard time and I know it means something different and the Amplified can help, then I'll take each Greek word and I'll write down the Greek word and then I'll go look it up in the Vine's expanded dictionary and I'll write down what it means. And I actually got a concordance that's shorter, so it's both.
Yeah.
And I'll write down that whole verse or two or three using the Greek to expand, sort of like the Amplified does, but yeah. doing it exactly out of the Greek. And that's how I can do it, because I don't understand Greek.
I think, you know, in giving a witness to somebody or a testimony, to keep yourself from saying, to keep that person from being able to say, hey, you're judging me or whatever, if we just say, well, just let me show you what the Bible says. Don't take it up with me. Let me show you what the Bible says. That's what this word means. This word means this.
Yeah. Well, that's what I try to do that with the Amplified Classic, and they so just go to the Greek. Yeah. I try to do that, and they get worse when I do the First Corinthians.
And you know why? Because it's just right there in your face. I mean, this is what Jesus says. Yeah. Don't get mad. Just the messenger.
Yeah. Well, it says we are to judge those sinning inside the church, and you're to throw them out. And if someone's in sexual sin, it says. And it's even more than that. It does other ones. But right. If they continue to do that, you're not even to eat with them at all.
No.
That's what the Bible says. I don't say it.
Right.
Well, take that out of your own eye. And then that's where, man, these
were
the...
There's another thing that's in that article. You got to read that article until you go home today.
The ones that I really... Proverbs 27:5, an open rebuke is better than hidden love.
Yeah.
I got there's a few. It won't be too far. I got them all. I did a thing on it a few months ago or a few years ago, and then it came up as a memory, and it just shows that. Where are you at? Come on, you can't be too far here. A friend is loyal, always loyal, and a brother is born to help in the time of need. Mockers hate to be corrected, so they stay away from the wise. A wise person hungry for knowledge, but wise fool feeds on trash. Commit your actions to the Lord and your plans will succeed. Those who listen to instruction will prosper. Those who trust the Lord will be joyful. A single rebuke does more for a person of understanding than 100 lashes on the back of a fool. It is safer to meet a bear robbed of her cubs than to confront a fool caught in foolishness.
A person of understanding.
I know. Don't waste what is holy on the pigs or they will trample you.
Yeah.
Those are Jesus' words. I mean, straight out of Jesus' words. So.
I got to go. I didn't know we've been, you know how long we've been here?
Did you see Rachel called?
Huh?
Sorry, Rachel.
Cheryl?
Yeah.
Yeah, I just saw
okay.
that.
Sorry.
I just saw that.
I thought she called a long time ago, but I couldn't tell.
She
it was
did.
A
I didn't
thing.
Know. I didn't know.
I saw a picture, but I mean,
she's
it's
called
like,
twice.
Oh, I know. I saw it once.
Okay.
We ain't been there that long. We only been here 2 hours, but I know it's a Saturday and it flies. It flies. I just saw a picture. That all I saw was a circle, so I don't
she's
know.
Fired. She's having. Oh, she asked for you to remember her in prayer for her sciatic nerves.
Okay.
She's still having issues with that thing.
Yep.
But. We need to do this more often.
Why? Oh, that's why I told them guys,
I'm still seeing dead roaches around my house. So I'm going, okay, John.
It's time to spray.
John's still here.
I'm going to tell you what, it's time to spray because okay. People are seeing. If you're seeing them, it is time just whenever. And I don't know your I know your schedule has changed. It used to be Tuesdays you left and then Mondays. And
we
so.
I leave out on Monday at 3 o'clock. So I have to give time for you. If you do it on a Monday, I have to give time for you to spray and for me to be gone. But on a Friday, and I'm off. I get home early Friday morning, anywhere from midnight till 4 a.m. And so I need to get a little sleep in there so I can get out of the house.
So you're home Friday night, Friday morning?
Friday morning.
Friday morning.
Early Friday morning.
So you're home Friday. You don't have to leave the house, though. Man, I'd spray with babies and stuff. You don't have to leave or not. But I know you. But I mean, you need your sleep and rest.
Real,
so
she's real sensitive
she
to
needs.
Anything.
Okay.
So, but she's been down with her leg and her back. So,
well, what we
I
can do? Look, I don't have to do anything inside. I'm telling you, I'll just do under the sinks, the around the dishwasher, the stove, the washing machine, the attic, and the outside, and we'll just that way y'all can be there. And if you don't, we don't have to do anything inside. Attic and outside is 95% of the pest control. You would be surprised. And you probably won't have anything. It's just the chemical outside is biodegrading and they're starting to come in the weep holes or they'll come up the house and they'll find their way in and they get in their attic and then they work their way in. These houses, how they're built here, we're not like up north where it's...
Well, here a couple of months ago, I had these little bitty ants, these little sugar, I call them sugar ants, and they're coming out of my radio on the wall, and they're going up and coming over to my cabinet, and I can't figure out where they are, so I had some home spray. But if I spray that, that's in the food, that's in the pantry.
Yeah.
I can't be doing that.
Yeah.
And so I just let them alone.
You go, man, I'll tell you what to get. I'll just come tomorrow or Monday and just drop some. For those, you just need bait. I just, if I'd have been in my other truck, I'd have it.
There's no place to set them. I tried to set one on top of the radio. You just go right around it.
No, well, then what I do with mine sometimes, I do that, orb. They're like little guns, and I can just push it, and you can just put a little, just little dots, and they'll go to it.
When you come over, they're not there now.
Okay,
I guess they got full. But what I was going to tell you, I was thinking about that this morning. Do you know how I found you?
You call problems. I mess with them. And solutions.
An older guy, he suggested you. And I was thinking about that today. I said, Ben, Lauren, how cool are you? I mean, whether that guy meant it for good or bad, he still got me to John.
Yeah. They know I do good work and I'm reasonable.
Yeah.
And whether, you know, even though it's a Christian.
He could have recommended anybody, though.
Yeah. He didn't give you three different ones?
I think he did.
Okay.
But, and I don't know, man.
I just been so long ago. I know.
Yeah. I just thought it was cool. What place does that? Nobody.
Oh, yeah,
does
they don't.
That.
No, they don't.
Nobody.
They got to be very careful because they have probably.
Big guys.
Well, no, they probably got, I mean, they got thousands of different companies that buy from them.
Yeah.
Thousands of people that buy their chemicals, just like me, big companies. So they got to be careful that this word doesn't get out to them and then they make somebody mad because they refer to this little guy because there's other chemical places to buy chemical from.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. Let's go, bro. Lord, I just love you and I thank you for my brother, John. Bless him in all of his endeavors, the things that he has to do and accomplish and work, but also openings, things that you do to allow the doors to open for the gospel to go through him. God, let his words be seasoned with salt. Let the anointing of the Holy Ghost be all over him, Father.
Yes.
And let him feel that anointing when he's ministering to people to know which way to go and how to speak to them. I ask you to bless him this very day, God. Lead him in the paths of righteousness for your name's sake, Lord. In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen. Lord, we thank you for this man, for the incredible testimony with him, and especially, it meant so much for him, but when his wife came and one day we talked, I went over there and she said, John, it just turned our life around, our spirits. What a blessing it was. And that just made me feel so honored to be able to listen to your word and go. And so this woman now is asking for your prayer, Lord, and we know that you are there to heal and take that pain away from that sciatica for her, Lord. I've had it and you've done it for me, so we ask that. We ask you to keep touching Ryan's, all of our kids' lives, but really for me, I need Ryan's lives touched. Open the doors for his racing. Keep opening the doors for him to see that I'm working for you and I'm not forcing anything on anybody. They come to you when they are ready. And bless my friend and his ministry and the other friend that we're talking to. And we thank you in Jesus' name. Amen. Hallelujah.